Welcome students. Today we will learn sensitivity analysis of project appraisal techniques. In this topic, we try to understand about the risks involved in the projects, and we try to analyze these risks and try to interpret the risks involved. And we try to reduce these risks, or we try to systematize these risks, and we make this attempt with a series of techniques that are available in this particular topic, that is project risk analysis. The first topic that we are going to learn in project risk analysis is about sensitivity analysis. Okay, so let us move on and try to learn what is the meaning of sensitivity analysis. Since the future is uncertain, you may like to know what will happen to the viability of the project when some variables like sales or investment deviates from its expected value. In other words, you may want to do what if analysis, or it is called as sensitivity analysis. Sensitivity analysis is a technique used to show the effects of changing one or more variables on an outcome. In other words, we call it as what if analysis. What is the importance of studying sensitivity analysis? The sensitivity analysis renders the model a dynamic characteristics that allows the analyst to check changes in optimum solution resulting from future changes in the data of the model. It deals with the study of changes in the optimum solution when the parameters of the problems are changed. Moving on to the merits of sensitivity analysis. First one, robust or vulnerable. It shows how robust or vulnerable a project is to change in value of the underlying variables. Point number two, it indicates whether further work may be done if the NPV is highly sensitive to changes in some factor. It may be worthwhile to explore how the vulnerability of that critical factors may be contained. Point number three, it is intensively very appealing as it articulates the concerns that project evaluators normally have. The next part is shortcomings of sensitivity analysis. Point number one, it merely shows what happens to NPV when there is a change in some variables without providing any idea of how likely that change will be. Point number two, typically in sensitivity analysis, only one variable is changed at a time. In the real world, however, variables tend to move together. Point number three, the interpretation of the results in this particular analysis is subjective. The same sensitivity analysis may lead one decision maker to accept the project while the other may reject the same project. So with this note, let us understand with the help of an example. On the screen, you are able to see a problem which explains about the situation of a particular company. You are supposed to identify the sensitivity of the project under three conditions. At the end of the problem, there are three conditions that are mentioned. There are three situations that are mentioned. We are asked to calculate the sensitivity of net present value to variations in quantity manufactured and sold, price per unit, and variable cost per unit. So here three sensitivity factors that are identified in this problem are quantity manufactured and sold. If we modify only the quantity manufactured and sold in three different situations, that is pessimistic situation, optimistic situation, and the expected situation, then what will be the resulting NPV under this situation? Then we will modify only the price per unit under all three situations or scenarios, that is expected scenario or situation, pessimistic scenario or situation, and optimistic scenario or situation. So what will be the impact on the net present value? Similarly, we also make changes in the variable cost per unit only, and then we will try to identify what is the impact on the NPV values, and then we will arrive at a conclusion. Let us try to solve this particular problem and understand how this particular variables impact on the net present value. Okay, students, now this is the question that we are going to solve and try to understand how the NPV changes in three different situations. Okay, so here I'm going to solve it. So first I'm going to study the sensitivity of net present value with respect to quantity manufactured and sold. So for this, let me pick up a table and let me insert. So I need a couple of rows and columns. Okay, so the first one we will name here it as a pessimistic situation. So the second one will be the expected situation, and the third one will be the optimistic situation, and this will be the particulars or the contents that we are going to enter. Okay, so in the question we saw the first item that we are going to pick up here is the initial investment. Okay, so the initial investment is 10,000. So here I'll put initial investment, and the amount is 10,000. In all the three situations, the initial investment will remain same. Okay, and then I'll select the sales revenue. The second component that comes is the sales revenue. Now, how do I calculate the sales revenue is what is important. Okay, so first let me take the expected situation sales revenue. How will I calculate the expected situation sales revenue? So here, if I just look at the quantity manufactured and sold annually is 1,000 units. Okay, so this 1,000 units multiplied by the price per unit, that is 1,000 into 20, that comes to 20,000. So I will put 20,000 over here. Okay, and similarly, let me pick up the values given. So here are the pessimistic values and the optimistic values that are given for quantity manufactured and sold. Okay, so the quantity manufactured and sold is 700 and price per unit is 20. So under pessimistic situation, the quantity manufactured and sold is 700 and the price per unit that I'm going to consider is 20. So this 700 multiplied by this 20, so this will amount to 14,000. So let me write 14,000 here under pessimistic situation. And similarly, for this optimistic situation, 1,400 quantity manufactured and sold, and this 1,400 multiplied by price per unit, that is 20. So we will consider this 1,400 multiplied by 20, this amounts to 28,000. So let me write 28,000 here. Okay. So moving on to the next part of the problem. So let me find out the variable cost. Okay. So the variable cost for the expected situation would be, so these 1,000 units multiplied by 15. So this will amount to 15,000. So this 1,000 multiplied by this variable cost per unit is 15,000 multiplied by 15. So this will amount to 15,000. Okay. Fine. Similarly, the pessimistic situation, that is 700 units multiplied by 15, will amount to 10,500. So this is 10,500. Let me enter 10,500 here. Similarly, 1,400 multiplied by 15. So this will amount to 21,000. So next is the fixed cost that we are going to consider. So in the problem, the fixed cost will not change. Of course, it is a fixed value that is given straight away in the problem. So we'll consider this 1,000 and we will put it across. So here, fixed cost will be 1,000 on all the three situations. Under all three situations, it will remain the same, that is 1,000. Let me align all of these values on one side. Fine. The next part that we are going to consider is depreciation. So now the depreciation, and the depreciation given in the problem is 1,000. Again, we will put it 1,000 over here as well in all the three situations. So it will not change for any of the situations. And the next what we are going to calculate is profit before taxes. So profit before tax is nothing but the sales revenue, that is 14,000 minus 10,500 minus 1,000 and minus 1,000. This will come to 1,500. And in the expected situation, similarly, 20,000 minus 15,000 minus 1,000 and minus 1,000, this will amount to 3,000. And the next optimistic situation, it will be 28,000 minus 21,000 minus 1,000 minus 1,000. So this should be 5,000. Okay, so moving on to the next part. So next we are supposed to calculate the tax. So tax given in the problem here is 20%. Okay, so on the profits, if I have to calculate 20% of these values, so 1,500 into 20%, this will amount to 300. Here it will amount to 600, and this will amount to 1,000. So similarly, if I deduct tax from the profits, so the profit after tax will come. So the profit after tax, after deducting the tax from the profit before tax, so 1,500 minus 300, so it will be 1,200 here. And the next one, this will be 2,400. And here it will be 4,000. So 1,500 minus 300, that is 1,200 in the pessimistic situation. In the expected situation, 3,000 minus 600, so this will amount to 2,400. And in the optimistic situation, 5,000 minus 1,000, this will be 4,000. Okay, so next part is the net cash flow. So we will calculate the net cash flow. So net cash flow is calculated as the profit after tax plus we will add back this depreciation. Okay, so profit after tax plus add back this depreciation. So we will get net cash flow here, 1200 plus 1000. So this will amount to 2200, and this will amount to 2400 plus 1000, 3400, and here 4000 plus 1000, this will amount to 5000. Okay, so we'll moving on to the next part. So net present value of PV factor at 11% for 7 years. If I have to check in the table, the present value, the present value interest factor annuity table at 11% for 7 years. So where this 11% and 7 years is given, if you just observe the question, so the life of this particular project is 7 years and the cost of capital is 11%. So if you just consider both of this, the 11% that is the cost of capital is a discount rate that we are going to consider, and life of the project is 7 years. So here the value that we are going to calculate is as follows. So to calculate net present value here, so 2200, that is the net cash flow for pessimistic situation, 2200 multiplied by 4.712 minus initial investment. So if I do it like this, 2200 multiplied by 4.712, so this will amount to 10,366.4, and if I deduct the initial investment for the pessimistic situation, that is this 10,000. So if I have to deduct 10,000 out of this, so the final figure, that is the net present value that I'm going to get, is 366.4. So is the value. Similarly, I have shown the calculation here. So similarly, if I calculate here, so this will amount to 6,021, and this will amount to 13,560. So this is the solution under the quantity manufactured and sold situation, sensitivity of net present value with respect to quantity manufactured and sold. Similarly, let me move on and try to calculate the sensitivity of NPV with respect to variations in unit price. Okay, so I'm going to understand the second situation now. Now we have understood the first situation, that is quantity manufactured and sold. Now we will try to understand price per unit. We will keep the quantities stagnant. We will not modify or change the quantity. The quantity will remain the same as 1000, and only the price per unit will vary. So in the expected situation, it will remain 20, and in the pessimistic situation, it will change to 18, and in the optimistic situation, it will change to 23. In the previous case, we changed the quantity manufactured and sold, and we checked the effect of that on the net present value, the sensitivity of this particular variable on the entire project. And if I want to see the sensitivity of this on the entire project, okay, so let me remove all the values on both the sides. The content will remain same, and the expected values will remain same. So as usual, the investment, the initial investment will remain same for all the three situations. And the sales revenue here in the pessimistic situation, so 1000 units, that is quantity manufactured and sold, and the price per unit is 18. So this will amount to 18,000. Okay. So, and here similarly, this will amount to 23,000. And the variable cost will remain constant for all the three situations. And the fixed cost and the depreciation will also remain constant as it is given in the problem. So, we will take down the same figures. Now, if you calculate the profit before tax, so here it will be 18,000 minus 15,000 minus 1,000 and minus 1,000. This will amount to 1,000. This will remain unchanged. And in the last section, so this will be 6,000. And the taxes, as usual, if you calculate 20%, so this will be 200. This will remain unchanged and this will be 1,200. And the profit after tax will be 800 and 2400 unchanged, and this will be 4800. And if I come down to net cash flow, here it will be 1800 and 3400 and 5800. Similarly, the net present value here, if I calculate, so it will be in the minus, that will be in the negative value. So minus 1518, so this will remain as it is. And here in the optimistic situation, 17,330. Okay, students, this is the second situation that we came across, that is sensitivity of net present value with respect to variations in the unit price. Now we will move on to the third situation given in the problem, that is sensitivity of net present value with respect to variations in the unit variable cost. The previous one was the price per unit. Okay, now we will try to understand the sensitivity of the project with respect to variable cost. Okay, so this is with respect to variations in the variable cost. So I'll copy this same table and I'll paste it over here. Okay, so I'll change the values. So the expected situation will remain same here as well, and only the certain values that we have to modify. The sales revenue will be intact, that is 1000 into 20. So we are going to modify only the variable cost per unit here, because this is the situation that we have to modify. So in the pessimistic variable cost, we are going to consider 16, 14, and here in the expected situation, it is 15. So similarly, if I have to calculate the sales revenue here will not change. So sales revenue will remain intact, that is 20,000 for all the three situations. Okay, so the variable cost will be in this situation. So 1000 into 16. So that will be 16,000. So 1000 into 15, that will be 15,000 here. And here in the optimistic situation, it will be 14,000. So similarly, fixed cost will remain unchanged and the depreciation will remain unchanged. So here also it will remain unchanged. The same values will appear. So 1000. So profit before tax in this particular situation, if I calculate 20,000 minus 16,000 minus 1000 minus 1000. So this will be 2000 profit before tax. Here it will remain unchanged. The last one will be 4000. And taxes here will be 400, and in the expected 600, in the optimistic it will be 800. Similarly, profit after tax, if I have to calculate, so 2000 minus 400, 1600, here it will remain unchanged. Here 4000 minus 800, 3200. So the net cash flow, if you have to calculate, so 1600 plus depreciation added back 1000, so this will amount to 2600. This will remain unchanged, so this will be optimistic situation will be 4200. And the if you calculate NPV at present factor interest, present value at interest factor annuity table, so this will amount to 2251. This will remain unchanged, and the last situation, that is optimistic situation, will be 9790. So these are the net present values in three different situations. So this is of a sensitivity analysis with respect to quantity manufactured and sold, and this is the table of sensitivity of net present value with respect to variations in unit price, and this is sensitivity of net present value with respect to variations in unit variable cost. So this is the problem. And what you have seen is the solution. Thank you, students. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share, and subscribe to this channel for future videos. Thank you very much.